The show business lifestyle is attractive to many. From the outside looking in, it seems like the new American dream. Fame, fortune, recognition, and attention all seem to come with the Hollywood lifestyle. However, the grass isn't always greener on the other side, as some who have experienced success in the industry early want to get out because it no longer serves them. This was the case with actor Ross Bagley, who found early success by appearing in the popular family film The Little Rascals and scoring a main role on the popular sitcom The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air a month apart from each other. This was his introduction into show business. After starting out hot, Bagley eventually took some time off and decided to put his focus elsewhere. Despite his retirement from acting, Bagley has got more than a few notable roles, which is why Ross Bagley will always be unforgotten. Born on December 5th, 1988, just 2 years before The Fresh Prince debuted on television, Ross Bagley immediately inserted himself in show business and enjoyed a successful career as a child actor. Bagley's first credited role came in 1994 at the age of 5. The role was iconic as Bagley played Buckwheat in The Little Rascals. The film was an adaptation of comedy shorts back in the 1920s, 30s, and 40s called Our Gang, which depicted a group of poor children and the adventures they got in. Spanky and Buckwheat and others became cultural icons. Eddie Murphy further popularized Buckwheat when he turned him to a recurring character during his time on Saturday Night Live. The film received mixed reviews upon release, with many criticizing the idea of sketching the concept for a comedy short into a full-length feature movie. However, the film was popular among children. Bagley, along with the rest of the cast, won a Young Artist Award for Best Performance by a Youth Ensemble in a Motion Picture. In the original shorts, the child actors were typecast in their roles and had difficulty finding work after. Luckily for Bagley, he didn't have the same problem. In 1994, The Little Rascals was released in August in theaters worldwide. The very next month in September, Bagley joined the cast of The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air as Nicky Banks, the fourth child of the Banks family. At the time, the show was in its fifth season and had survived the departure of Janet Huber, the show's original Aunt Viv. During the show's third season, Huber had gotten pregnant, so producers wrote it into the show. Without Janet's real-life pregnancy, the character probably wouldn't exist altogether. The character of Nicky was born towards the end of season 3 and was an infant the following season. Beginning with season 5, Nicky was in preschool. It was impossible to ignore the noticeable age jump. In the show, Nicky never really had his own storylines and was mainly used as a plot device for other characters. In 1995 and 1996, Bagley won two more Young Artist Awards for Best Performance by an Actor Under 10 in TV for his portrayal of Nicky. As a guest on the Hip Hop Uncensored podcast in 2020, Bagley said that Fresh Prince was his favorite show as a kid, and he was nervous when he finally got the chance to showcase his acting skills for the executives and producers of his favorite show. Bagley recalled on his final audition, he saw Will Smith and his jaw dropped with excitement. Bagley was able to shake his nerves, and after reading lines with Will, the audition turned out to be a success and he was told he got the role of Nicky Banks. For Bagley, it was a dream come true. After The Fresh Prince ended in May 1996, he had a small role in Will Smith's Independence Day, playing Will Smith's stepson. At the time, the film was Will's most successful film role and still remains a fan favorite to many. Again, Bagley was nominated for the best performance in a feature film by an actor under 10. However, he would lose the award, making it the first time he didn't take home a Young Artist Award. In the late 90s, Bagley continued to work. He appeared in single episodes of dramas Profiler and Providence in 1996 and 1999, respectively. In 1999, he lent his voice for an episode of The Wild Thornberries. There would be a 5-year gap between his next television role. That came in 2004 when he guest starred in an episode of Judging Amy. Bagley would be 15 years old. As Bagley had gotten older, it seems as though acting wasn't a passion of his, as he would have zero film or television roles between 2004 and 2015. In the same Hip Hop Uncensored interview, Bagley was asked about his disappearance from the industry. I wanted to live more of a normal type of life. I remember at the height of Fresh Prince, I would be getting chased out of malls, the whole nine. I live a relatively under the radar and generally that's how I am. I'm more laid back and reserved when people meet me. Even back then, they would ask my mom, does he talk? According to US Magazine, Bagley graduated from California State University, Northridge, and got an internship at Will Smith's production company, Overbrook Entertainment. In 2015, via Instagram, Bagley revealed that he was working as a realtor with Keller Williams Realty in Los Angeles. During Bagley's absence from show business, it appears he picked up DJing as a new hobby, performing under the name DJ Rossi B. In addition to his new hobby, around the same time, Bagley revealed he had a son named Reese. Bagley has been dedicating more time to being a father and a realtor instead of spending time in front of the screen. In 2014, Bagley would reunite with the Little Rascal co-stars for the film's 20th reunion. According to reports, it was difficult getting everyone together as some of the cast had left show business just like Bagley. A few haven't acted since the original 1994 film. The reunion was supplemented with a photo shoot and an interview with TMZ. In 2015, Bagley would step in front of the camera for the first time since 2004 for the films Gnome Alone and Dead Ringer. Bagley was most recently seen in the 30th anniversary special of The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, where he joined all of his co-stars. It would be the first time most fans had seen Bagley with his old TV family, as he was absent during the cast's previous get-togethers. Ross Bagley managed to pull off a lot with his short time in the industry and was able to touch millions while doing so. His roles as Buck Wheat and Nicky Banks are widely remembered and celebrated. Both were so iconic, they've required reunion special years later. Some actors spend decades chasing their first big break, but Ross Bagley accomplished that with his first two roles. As a child actor, he was mischievous, silly, imaginative, and witty. Nicky Banks lit up our screens whenever he appeared, and that's why Ross Bagley will always remain unforgotten.